here's what I want to do. Welcome, folks. Thank you for joining us on this Wednesday, the 22nd day of July 2015 transmission. Here's what I want to do. I want to take phone calls, and in the first hour, I want to actually go to your calls early and open the phones up for a free-for-all for first-time callers on Jade Helm, on Obama announcing outside of law that he's going to go after Social Security recipients' firearms ownership, on the fiat open borders, on the meltdown in China and Greece, on the political correctness getting more and more extreme, on the hundreds of issues that are out there, on the Planned Parenthood videos, the latest one coming out yesterday and causing a firestorm in the real media online, but almost no coverage on the controlled corporate press, where the national chairman of the committee that runs Planned Parenthood, a medical doctor, haggling about the price of organs from babies. That chilling audio and video. Extremely ghoulish. We need to discuss all of this, but as a central thread, we need to also talk about why the ruling technocrats, the ruling social engineers, want to sabotage the human condition, want us dumbed down, and want us basically set up for a major fall. What is the end game strategy? Well, they are neo-eugenicist, or what I would call transhumanist. Now, there is a pop transhumanist movement that sounds very, very good. They even have their own presidential party here in the United States, led by Zoltan Istvan. And I'm not joking when I cover that headline. The U.S. presidential candidate doesn't want to be president. He wants to live forever. And he's talking about deploying all this technology to the general public. So he's kind of like the good version of what the globalists have already launched. But if we can't get the public to get past the latest Miley Cyrus hair under her arms or Jenner's wearing a dress story, if we can't get past the latest dig up a Confederate general's body and debate and discuss what's already been decided, we don't have any hope. So I thought I'd go over some of this article. Zoltan Istvan was among the earliest candidates to declare the bid for 2016 U.S. presidential election. But most Americans still won't know about this writer and transhumanist philosopher by the time they head to the polls. And he knows that. Yet his platform is refreshing. Put science first. His ideas are radical, which is not uncommon for third-party candidates. But they're also appealing. Make college education mandatory and free. Create policy so that everyone can have designer babies, not just the rich, and discover immortality in the next 10 to 15 years, or 15 to 20 years. He represents the Transhumanist Party, which claims to have at its root the philosophical thoughts going back centuries and has a core aim of building technologies that will give us superhuman powers. The tools they believe that will empower us. The total number of members of humanity, plus the biggest such membership organization, is only 10,000. His campaign, which includes a bus shaped to represent a coffin, is run with the help of a group of volunteers in California. So these are kind of like the porch masons. They're not on the inside, but they know what's going on, and they want access to what the establishment is building in its giant New World Order plan that's about 100 times bigger than the Manhattan Project. This is the InfoWar. I'm your host, Alex Jones. It is now Wednesday, the 22nd day of July, 2015, and we have cleared the deck of guests yet again because there's so much breaking news, we need to cover it all, or at least try. I also want to open the phones in this first hour into the second hour for first-time callers, and then a total free-for-all for everybody in the third hour. I have a tendency to get stuck covering news and basically ranting and then don't go to your calls in the first hour. So on any issue you want to raise, any question, any comment, agree, disagree, I'd want to hear from you if you're a first-time caller. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. That intro that we just played has been out for about 2 years. It's an intro piece put together by Darren McBreen here at InfoWars. And it illustrates the 1970s sci-fi nightmare dystopic film Soylent Green, detailing a global environmental collapse as the oceans die and food production going to almost zero, so that euthanized humans then become the main food product. And then we juxtapose it with real headlines from today. 4 years ago, I talked about how elites in Asia, but also throughout the world, were having babies melted down for their collagen, for injections, and for pills to be ingested, and how they were constantly catching babies wrapped in gold foil being shipped into South Korean, North Korean, Chinese, and other elites, and how the practice of eating smoked baby was entering the West. Now, that's mainstream news buried. That's in FBI reports. That's in Interpol reports. And they probably had, let's not exaggerate, more than 20 publications, mainly fake conservative, fake libertarian, come out and attack me and say that I was insane and a liar. Because while bullhorning the Bilderberg Group in Virginia, where they were meeting, I pointed out, it's been in the news recently that there's a traffic in baby parts around the world, powdered babies. Babies wrapped in gold foil. And this is the exact type of elite that is involved in that. And they took that and said, Alex says the Bilderberg Group is eating babies in foil, and made a big joke out of it. No, they're launching wars that killed over 1 million Iraqis. They're launching global programs where IBM computers ration care and put veterans on death lists. They're now deploying that to Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid. They're launching programs worldwide where they've disarmed every population but the U.S. and Switzerland. They're launching programs worldwide of forced inoculations that sterilize women. And they've gotten caught. It's been in mainstream Indian, African, and European news. They're busy creating weaponized flus. These are really villainous folks. And now we have Planned Parenthood, not one but two videos. One, their director of services, medical services, and then now the national director, the president of Planned Parenthood's council, their board, the head of their board of directors. Who else headed up the board of directors previously? Bill Gates's Army Intelligence father, who was hired by IBM. We know that. Back then, Congress would still break up trust in the 70s. IBM's full wealth is behind eugenics, always has been since before the days when Thomas Watson was Hitler's right-hand man. And so they created Microsoft as their front, and we are now under them today. Bill Gates wants to break up your family. He wants to forcibly inoculate you. He wants euthanasia. He wants abortion on demand. And you don't even hear the so-called right-wing radio ever attack him because he's too big to touch. I have been threatened specifically to shut my mouth about Bill Gates. His wife 2 years ago in Germany said, those of you out there claiming we're running a worldwide eugenics extermination program, better watch it. If you don't shut your mouth, people are going to start dying. And the news went, does she mean we're stopping her from saving people? No, it was a public death threat. Well, somebody's got to stand up against Warren Buffett and Bill and Melinda Gates. But all the Confederate flag baloney, all the infighting, all of it. You need to understand you're idiots when you involve yourself in this infighting and all this mindlessness when we're dealing with hardcore globalists that ghoulishly are involved in the sale of baby organs, you name it. I mean, Apple is a monopolistic company that runs factories in China that have suicide nets around them, forced abortions, and 18-hour workdays. But it's okay because Bill Clinton's involved and Al Gore's on their board and they've got guys wearing, you know, different colored socks at board meetings going, hi, we're non-threatening, we're liberal. Oh, hi. Oh. It's a total camouflage. It's a 21st century takeover. We're designed to see an enemy in a uniform coming over the fence, coming up to the drawbridge, and to fight back. We're designed to fight tanks, not banks. And the banks have stolen the world's wealth. Now they need to secure it. And there's no reason to have 7.5 billion people eating into resources they've stolen. And you can see the argument that there are 7.5 billion destructive people fighting with each other, dumbed down, being petulant. Why not just wipe them all out and start over and play God? First by water, then by fire, the Bible says. Well, first by water, then by the globalist, playing God with soft kill. So first by water, then by soft kill. Whether you believe the Old Testament Genesis or not, the point is the globalists believe they're God, they're playing God, they're in control, they're already in breakaway civilization systems, and the decision has been made to accelerate, to intensify the poisoning of your food and water. The dumbing down, the weaponization of media. There is this giant program going on that, no kidding, is at least, I've been thinking about this a lot and looking at the numbers, 100 times bigger than the Manhattan Project. They've spent over $100 billion in PR for global warming taxes since 1992. Look up the numbers. That's the UN's own numbers. Like $112 billion last time I checked a year ago. That's $112 billion just for propaganda. To get you to believe you're bad, you're killing the earth, so you accept being basically taken out, being restricted, being enslaved. So the toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231. Just today, I have stacks of news going, the end of humanity's here, it's going to be wonderful, the end of our species is nigh, oh, humans are horrible, oh, with competing transhumanist propaganda, so we accept this takeover as if we're going to get part of it. We're going to be tested on, we're going to be given the leavings of all of this. But here it is, Wired Magazine, a huge report, the Genesis Engine. We now have the power to quickly and easily alter DNA. It could eliminate disease. It could solve world hunger. It could provide unlimited clean energy. It could really get out of hand. Well, they're not going to let it get out of hand. That's what world government's about. You're not getting access. I'm not getting access. This is what shadow world government's all about. So here's the big enchilada. Then we're going to break. I'm coming back and taking your calls. I'm going to say it again. It's just an emergency alert. I've got hundreds of news articles, all incredibly important, incredibly entertaining, incredibly riveting. Imminent mass earthquakes for San Francisco, USGS. It's all off the chart. But we have the future being stolen by the globalists. They think we're so dumb, they write white papers about it 50 years ago. They've done everything they said they would do so far. And the next step, it gets really nasty. The extermination of the world population. Done under the guise of natural plagues, bioweapon plagues released by shadowy terror groups that are really the globalists. Huge wars, food shortages, as the West gives up its liberty during the coming totalitarianism as a way of maintaining safety. And people pledge themselves to the corporate Borg to do anything to have access to the life extension technologies. And that's why they've got to have a total shadow world government that is above the law, diplomatically immune, with unlimited taxes. $100 trillion every decade is what they're asking for day one. All public. The elite just everywhere in their white papers just laugh and just say, try to stop us. We'll step on you like a bug. And then people want me to fight with them over what color they are, or that I'm close-minded because I don't like an old Olympic athlete in drag. I just don't care. It's a weapon system to psychologically distract us from the scientific, technological, military takeover taking place. The humans are all going to be replaced with the military in the next 10 to 15 years. They're going to implode the military, which has had its own problems, but at least was a human institution. They're destroying the family successfully. They're destroying our health. They're destroying our physical IQ. They are annihilating everyone right now. I mean, we're watching people being torn to pieces in slow motion. And so all this other news is just window dressing. But just in my stacks today, not one, not two, not three, not four, not five, not six, there's like eight different articles announcing how ugly and bad humans are and how much better we'll be when we're all dead. That's their philosophy being projected onto us, so we lay down. And other articles about how, yes, they've already got life extension, but we can't give it to the general public. I mean, why not admit what's going on, be honest, build up humanity, create giant human endeavors for space colonies in near-Earth orbit? Why not really empower humanity instead of keeping folks in the dark and trying to dumb humanity down and remove it? And then you look at the elites, who they are. They're very wicked, evil, hateful people. And I don't know how I'm not supposed to just talk about this, because this is what's really going on. Why do I call it a giant Manhattan Project? David Rockefeller famously in 1991 in Evian, France, and this was released to the BBC, thanked the media for keeping their organization for world government secret and said our goals would have been impossible if we would have had the light of publicity on it. But now the end of the nation state and the end of individual determination is over, and the dawn of a world government run by policymakers and international bankers is now here. I mean, go read his quote. This is a man who praised when Mao Zedong died in the New York Times, communism and what Mao Zedong did. Mao Zedong killed 84 million people, if you believe the Chinese government. Our government says 60 plus mil. I mean, do you understand? This guy founded over 100 world government organizations. The Carnegie, the Ford, the Rockefeller Foundations are all under their control. And everything you see being done is from them. Microsoft, IBM, all of it, everything, the global rollout, global standardization, it's been decided by them. And I guess people just want to be ruled in a sci-fi nightmare, taken over, dumbed down, and then euthanized by these people. While they openly drink wine and go, ah, baby parts, Lamborghinis, ah. I mean, my father was in the top six smartest people in Texas, tested by UT when he was a junior in high school, and they called little David Jones in and basically told him a bunch of this when he was 16 years old. He didn't even tell me about it until I was like 30 years old. That's how ubiquitous this is, that even my dad almost joined this cult and never even told me about it. So there's a revolution against common sense, a revolution against due process, a revolution against the common person's private property rights, your rights to live your life as you see fit. Whether it's illegal NSA spying or the GMO crops, all of it is designed to undermine the individual and to atomize communities and to break us down so we can't stand up against intensified oppression that's coming. This is the globalist system. And there is a giant quasi-secret planetary government being established. And people don't ask, what's the philosophy of the world government? What's the philosophy of the group involved? Well, they go, and this has been declassified. We've had insiders on. We've had historians from Congress on. Going over every angle of it. But basically, they recruit all the top test score people, all the top mathematicians, all the top writers, top philosophers from every discipline, and tell them, you're smart, you're part of the elite, the general public are a bunch of scum, we're going to save the earth by bringing in a global tyranny, a global authoritarianism, and you're going to be part of the leadership of it. That's very alluring, and most people go along with it. And that's where we are today. And then as you get higher up in it, into the 6,000 superclass estimated by the Kissinger Group, and I agree with that number, then you're let into the larger design of basically total exterminism, Luciferianism, we are gods, we are merging with the machines to transcend, and the profane do not deserve to transcend. And so we must see a falling away, a culling. And this is what Prince Philip, the Queen of England's husband, talked about earlier this week. Another statement about getting rid of people. Another statement of, when do we start killing everybody? A creepy 90-something-year-old man in a science fiction-esque military uniform. But you know what? I guess they kind of deserve to wear those. I mean, they funded the science of the total takeover. They run the whole system, and they put poison in you and your children's water, and they make money off global flesh and organ trafficking, narcotics trafficking. They own Dutch Royal Shell with their cousin, the Queen of the Netherlands, and British Petroleum. And they have married in with the Rothschilds. It's their planet. It's their club. And you and I, as George Carlin said, ain't in it. And let me tell you why the test scores never get better. Because they want us dumb. And we're going to get stupider and stupider. Because the owners don't want you thinking. So we were able to interview George Carlin before he died, our reporters. He said, no, I don't buy 9/11. Looks like a stage to me. Take our freedoms, but I'm done talking to you, because what's it going to do anyways? Public doesn't care. Next person for me to sign my book. George Carlin. He's a smart guy. His dad was one of the top PR men in New York City for some of the biggest publications in the country, and he grew up learning all about BS. But how do you then get that information to the public that doesn't want to believe it? And then Fox News attacked George Carlin. Of course, it's come out now that Saudi Arabia quarterbacked the entire attack. I said that within a week of 9/11. And then our government stood down bare minimum. That means they aided and abetted the attacks. We're proven right, yet again. Because it's not just that they don't care about your lives. It's a religion of hating you. And thinking of you as trash, thinking of you as a commodity. And if you won't stand up for yourself and get aggressive, if you won't stand up for veterans being put on don't treat list and death list, if you won't stand up for unborn, nobody is going to stand up for you. And I'll just say it again, the God of this universe is not going to stand up for you either. It's just going to say, hey, listen, I don't know who you are. You don't resonate with what I'm about. Go be with other people like yourself. Let your spirit, let your energy, let your soul go be with other people like you. That place has a name interdimensionally. You could use a Superman-esque thing, the Phantom Zone. That's where you people get to go. But see, they tell the general public, oh, there's no such thing as God or the devil. But then you study globalist, They themselves are seriously occultic, to a man, to a woman, and they believe they serve the God of this world, who is the real Christ, who is going to deliver them with technology and make them live forever with heaven on earth. They are a whacked out eugenics, proto-Nazi, neo-eugenics death cult. And they have White House-run publications, you know, make jokes about that when I come out and I say, the UN's a space cult. Well, my full quote was, Ian Fleming, Moonraker cult. I mean, Heaven's Gate, Hail Bop cult, put on their Nike tennis shoes, took their barbiturates, drank their vodka, suited up to send their spirits up to join the flying saucer, and they all had chopped their genitals off, because the space aliens wanted those chopped off in their fruitcake land. And then I look at what the UN and the globalists push. It's basically the same thing. We're all going to drink Kool-Aid and then go to the mothership. We're going to join with the world government and then we're going to live forever. No, you're not. It's a giant deception. How do you get people to join with the devil? To join with death? To join with a God that wants to kill everybody on the earth? To save the earth as you merge with machines and become gods. Do you think the elite are going to take this old woman, the head of the Planned Parenthood board, who's out haggling over bodies, drinking expensive wine, haggling over baby organs, getting sick looks in her eye when she talks about Lamborghinis? Do you really think the elite, her bosses, are going to give her access to the life extension fully? No. They're going to wipe you out. And by the way, to the actual controllers, in your gut, in your soul, in your spirit, do you really think the God of this world, the old serpent, the deceiver, the betrayer, is going to give you this power over the earth you think you're going to get? You're only given limited power to bring this thing in. And once you bring this in, you are going to be the most despised, hated people, and it says you're going to hide under the mountains and beg for death, but you won't be able to die. Because, see, you didn't want to die, did you? Did you? Right here, the Genesis Engine. Wired Magazine, special report. It's like 30 pages long. We now have the power to quickly and easily alter DNA. It could eliminate disease. It could solve world hunger. It could provide unlimited clean energy. It could really get out of hand. By Amy Waxman. It needs to be specially controlled, the life extension. And then what's deployed to the public will have Trojan horses in it and will not be the real grail. Because just as the elite are betrayed by their masters and their master, they do the same trick to those below them, and then that group betrays those below them as well. As above, so below, follow your own rules, your own alchemy, and realize what you've done. You will not attain the next level of human development by trying to hold other people back. Universal galactic rule that cannot be controverted. That's written on my heart. I don't believe it. I know it. You have proven yourself to be cosmic con artists like your father. You have proven yourself to be failures and cheats. You are failing your boot camp inspection on this rock. You're a joke. Now, I said I'd take a bunch of calls, first-time callers in this hour and the next, and as usual, I'm not doing it because I get so obsessed with the info, but just look at these headlines. These superhumans are real, and their DNA could be worth billions. Bloomberg. That's why they've been taking your blood at birth and stockpiling it and mass-producing it and then telling you later they've patented your DNA so you can't even have access to it. And yes, there are X-Men-type qualities in people out there. Not like in the movies where you're shooting fireballs out of your hands, but people that can go underwater longer, people that have higher IQs, people that can defeat cancer quicker. It's all there. But believe me, that's not going to be given to the general public. You notice the more of this technology we get, the more sick we get. We'll get to the new transhumanist party and what they want. It's all coming up. The bionic eye that could cure blindness. And the push for euthanasia, Dr. Death's Edinburgh Fringe 2015 show, will see Right to Die campaigner gas the audience. Just like Bill Gates was releasing mosquitoes on his audience. So right as we're told we have all this life extension, we're told, but we got to go ahead and kill old people because you kill grandma, you get 10 jobs as teachers. No, you take care of grandma and build an economy around caring about people, and now you have an economy. Instead, they're removing everything where you don't have jobs, saying that creates an economy. We can have any economy we want. We could already have space bases on record, totally feasible ring cities with gravity designed exactly like Elysium. That's a 1920s Wernher von Braun design you see in that movie. The same guy in the 30s came up with the space shuttle diagram when he wasn't sitting at Hitler's knee. But that's what we're dealing with here, people. This is the issue. And this broadcast, the fact that we understand what's going on. Notice we were talking about this before this was in the news. Because they're getting ready to go more and more operational with all this. All right, I want to go to your phone calls very briefly here. We have the new formula from InfoWarsLife.com. I have trouble sleeping sometimes, especially when I'm up working late, and then I just can't go to sleep. You know, once you go past that 1 or 2 in the morning, sometimes on the road or doing coast-to-coast AM or whatever, then I can't turn it off, can't go to sleep. And melatonin works a little bit, valerian some, but if I took them together, I noticed it was a lot more powerful. So then I said, I want something called Knockout. This is over a year ago. That has everything that's known to work safely together, organic, to absolutely poleaxe somebody within an hour of taking it. Takes me about 45 minutes to be uncontrollably sleepy. It's got gamma, aminoburitic acid, L-theanine, hops, flower extract, lemon balm and leaf extract, valerian root extract, chamomile flower extract, L-tryptophan, melatonin. And it is a very good dose of each one of these. Consult your physicians or healthcare providers before you give it to any young people or teenagers. But it is certainly a game changer. It's available at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. We did sell out of Super Male Vitality. It won't be back in for a while. Super Female is still available. And basically, it's the same thing. It's just got a couple different ingredients in it and does pretty much the same thing. I think it works better than the Super Male, but group disagrees. It varies person to person. So that's great if you want to try it. Super Female Vitality, InfoWarsLife.com. X2 is set to sell out any day, and it could be quite a while till we get more in. We hope something's coming in the next few weeks. InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. Now, after I take calls right into the next hour, at the bottom of the next hour, I'm going to get into USGS scientists, major quake on Hayward Fault expected any day now, bigger than the 4.0 that hit Tuesday. CBS News. 470,000 vehicles at risk after hackers take control of a Jeep and crash it. Zero Hedge up on InfoWars.com. Family threatened with government fine for parking cars in their own driveway. British Foreign Secretary advocates totalitarianism in fight against ISIS and Russia. We'll get into the Obama, Clinton, Cloward, and Piven strategy. The McCain POW cover-up. WorldNet Daily does a detailed breakdown of what we talked about. The fact that he's been absolutely instrumental covering up and not getting POWs returned. That's been his job all along. He's such a traitor. But they use somebody who they've sold as this hero to then betray the military, as we know. He's also for open borders, an anti-gunner, a total globalist. A new NASA study lays out a plan to return humans to the moon. Confirmed Obama to confiscate retirees' guns. And we had a investigative journalist on yesterday from Daily Caller who got the FBI memo, and he's published it, where it says if you do automatic wire transfers for your Social Security check, they're going to say you're inept and take your guns. Just any reason. They're now going to use the model they've used on vets for retirees, and they've got the major retiree organizations working with them. So just a massive line in the sand being crossed on that front. That video and documents are up on Infowars.com. Confirmed Obama to confiscate retirees' guns. People don't get upset about this. It's going to get really serious. This is all outside of law. Nanny State of the Week. Lawsuit challenges Seattle trash snooping, where they dig through your trash and make sure you're doing everything you're supposed to. They also scan the RFID on the products in your trash, so I told folks they would do a decade ago, and then fine you massively without a warrant. Fed spent $125,000 studying sexist adjectives. They want to basically restrict the word aggressive when describing a woman. You're not allowed to say a woman's bossy or aggressive or anything. It is sexist and is criminal, basically, if they have their way. Just total police state, total cult, beyond anything ever imagined. Just foaming, frothing evil. President Obama finally orders flags to fly at half-mast to honor Chattanooga shooting victims. Within minutes of the Supreme Court decision, had the White House go rainbow because they knew it was all staged and blackmailed. And again, this whole gay marriage thing, I'm not against people individually. Everybody knows that. It's that it's about breaking up the family and then coming in and saying you can't have single family dwellings and we're going to have tax increases on people that have kids. And that's what we see now. Can't have the name mother or father. Boy or girl's hateful. You got to be purple penguins. It's the removal of language and a scientific attack on the species. It's a devastating operation. All right, I'm going right to your phone calls when we come back to Tony, David, Alex, Chris, Cameron, and others. Notice that the system doesn't want us to have any real philosophy, any real culture. Just a petty, mindless, politically correct, obsessed, domesticated nanny state. Kids get taken from their parents if they're 11 years old and play in their backyard. Dodgeball's banned. Words are banned. Everyone's taught how to comply with cult-like language controls, but not taught how to engage in engineering or agrarian activities. It's a takeover. And so my broadcast, more than anything, is designed to get people talking about the real architecture of the global system and where it's going. Now, I'm going to stop talking about it until the third hour. I'm going to actually get into this amazing Wired Magazine article, The Genesis Engine. And I want to go to your calls now. Better late than never. I'm going to them, Tony and others. And we'll just take calls on all the different wild card issues right through the next hour. No guest today. Let's go ahead and talk to Tony in Florida. Thanks for holding. You're the first caller.
Hey, how you doing, Alex? I want to thank you for what you do, fighting the globalists on a daily basis, and your team.
Thank you.
I just had a quick question. We're seeing, I'm Hispanic, and we're seeing all these attacks against Donald Trump and basically these institutions that have been, you know, have built this country, marriage, school with your kids, just everywhere. We're being attacked everywhere. And I wanted to ask you, do you think that we as a people in the U.S. now are in New World Order?
Yes, we are now under world government, and then it just gets worse from here. I mean, that's the thing. People think like world government's like Star Trek, everybody's kumbaya. No, the New World Order is the Borg, literally. I mean, it is the takeover of the machines and the globalist, and then once they have their world government in place, which is about 90% in place, then they ban the cash, then they set up the taxes and regulations where it's impossible to be independent. I was talking to a banker yesterday who runs a good-sized Texas bank. He said, you're absolutely right. Since 2008, the big banks that caused the crisis have set up stuff where we're out of housing loans. We're out of everything now. They're just shutting down all small banks. Well, that's what it is on every front. It's a consolidation, a takeover, not to just have a monopoly, but to be able to then dictate behavior to everyone. Go ahead.
Yeah, now it's just, it's insane. You hit the nail right on the head there. Everything now is racist. Donald Trump's saying no country runs with open borders in the world. I'm from Cuba, and they don't have gay marriage there. And here, now we have it, and everybody's acting like if it's all great and lovely. But these countries that people like Obama and others want to bring us towards don't even have what we have here, and then they call us bad. It's crazy.
Yeah, you can't go to Cuba as an American and have your baby for free and get free welfare. They laugh at you. They work people super hard in Cuba, from what I've read and talking to Cuban refugees. But see, it's all sold as happy in a wonderland for the public. I mean, imagine saying, you can come here, we're going to give you everything free.
It's only
designed to drive down wages. But again, I don't dislike the people that are coming in. I realize they're being used as a tool. I mean, like water. I love water. I love a lake. I love to take a shower. But the tens of millions of illegals pouring in are like a broken dam. It can also overturn your house and kill you. So I don't hate water, but it's a very powerful force, like a fire hose crammed down your throat will kill you. And basically, they've got a fire hose of illegal immigration and some of the worst immigrants you could get now shoved down our throat, blowing our guts out. God bless you. Where do you think it's all going, Tony?
I really am not sure. I just told my family, hey, if we are starting to go towards Cuba, I'm just going to go ahead and move back there because we're all going to be the same anyway. So I'd rather go where I was born. But
I hear you. You may have to go to a totalitarian country because it'll be better than here. I was talking to a guy about that last night. Door number two, I want to take a ton of calls this hour. We've canceled some of the guests, so I wanted to have time to get everybody's phone calls. We're going to get into the latest on the police state, the latest on the election, the latest on the crucifixion of Donald Trump and what's really behind the traitor, not just the non-hero, John McCain. But for some reason, no one's going after him for his real record. WorldNet Daily has published an excellent article breaking it all down. But before we get into any of that, I want to go back to your phone calls right now. Let's go ahead and talk to David in Michigan. Thanks for holding.
Hi, Alex. I got a couple things I want to bring up. First off, I'm about 55 to 60 miles from Camp Graylin. And we've had a lot of activity, a lot of flying over. Now we're getting Apaches coming over, Chinooks flying in formation, especially over our rivers and all our farmland up here. I'm with the Amish. I'm near the Amish. And it's just been increasingly going for the last, 60 days now. And now they got troops that hanging out besides on some of these things. And to me, they had different insignias. But it's weird about the Apaches. They're all black. No insignias on the tail or anywhere. But the Chinooks, that's all military. You could tell U.S. The second thing I want to bring up is all these estate auctions that are going on here in Michigan. We have guys that, or a couple people that we confronted that have been buying up all the rifles from all the other people, and we believe that they're federal agents. They're not letting the people buy guns. They're buying anything that shoots a projectile. And I think that's very odd. We tried to confront one of the guys because he was at the same auction, different places, you know, in 3 weeks. So I don't know what your take is on that or if you heard anything on that.
Well, I mean, we know that there have been billions of rounds of ammunition that have been bought by the federal government the last 4 years. It's over $3 billion now total. And hundreds of millions of them were every weird caliber, weird Mauser stuff from World War I, 44, 45, 30-odd-6. That's not used by NATO. It's 308. On and on and on. Just hundreds. Kit Daniels wrote a story about it last year. Just hundreds of just every caliber you can imagine buying it up. And that's meant to drive up prices. They're also buying up just massive loads of different calibers. They've been caught shipping them over to the Free Syrian Army. They've been caught outfitting other groups. There's a whole bunch of weird clandestine operations going on. While Obama had the last lead smelting facility in the U.S. shut down last year, and now they're restricting Chinese shipping lead in. So they're just hitting the gun industry and the right to self-defense at every level. But the big shoe to drop is the fact that we had the Daily Caller reporter on yesterday. The FBI memo said they're going to use the system the VA uses to where if you even do automatic money transfer of your Social Security check, they're going to then restrict your Second Amendment. They're going to test it out and see if people get upset. But you're about to see, if they follow the past model, tens of thousands a month of Social Security recipients, just as they did with the VA, denied their guns. And then if that gets to be a big enough controversy, they may back off. If it doesn't, then it'll be hundreds of thousands a month, as Clinton did right before he left office. Now Obama has started this again. Hundreds of thousands of vets a month can't buy guns now. And they won't even tell them, just like a no-fly list, why their record says that they can't have a gun. Now, the law doesn't say that. They haven't been adjudicated mentally ill or incompetent. They're just doing it, just like they're shutting the power plants down or they're opening the borders by fiat. This is the essence of living under a dictatorship, and we're now seeing it like smellless nerve gas entering a building, wiping out our Second Amendment. It's creeping death, brother.
Oh, yeah, and I see them mapping. I mean, there's the only reason they'd be going over this lake on this day and then the next day at another lake over in the same area, but, you know, a mile apart from each other. It's just weird.
The military's good men and women on average. They're training them to engage us. They're training them so when they use them against us, they'll say, well, we've been doing this for years. I mean, we took guns in Katrina. Big deal. We're just following orders. By the way, in the third hour, I'm going to open the phones up for folks with Jade Helm intel. Whatever happened to Jade Helm? The modern environmentalists are really a death cult, a power cult. So they keep saying the Earth's going to collapse, you're going to starve, you're not going to have any food because of global warming, now climate change. But then they move politically to shut off resources at a planetary level. I'm going to cover some of this at the bottom of the hour and continue with calls. I'm going to calls right now. Jerry Brown's climate warning. We are talking about extinction. That's coming up. This is big news. House Republican, Obama administration won't release full Iran deal to Congress. Congress has to approve treaties and agreements. Congress is supposed to control the purse, but more and more, from open borders to our power plants being turned off to executive action against the Second Amendment, that's not happening. The presidency is becoming truly dictatorial, truly imperial. And that's what the special interests want. So we're going to be going over that report. What's really going on with Donald Trump? He's right about John McCain. There's a WorldNet Daily article that shows McCain covering up the POW situation. That's why the POWs hate him. That's why POWs that were with him at the Hanoi Hilton said he was never tortured. He was kept in a nice area as a trustee, was given women. Had lavish meals, and they just turned him into this big hero. We know he's an anti-gun, open border, Keating 5, scam artist, criminal, piece of filth. So why isn't Donald Trump going after him on the real issues? They say Donald Trump is headed towards the Texas border. I want to send Joe Biggs or Jakari Jackson or somebody down there to cover that. That's going to be a three-ring circus. But why would Trump come out and say, oh, if you get shot down, you know, and get captured, you're not a hero. I don't want you to get captured. No, people that fly into dangerous areas and get shot down and to areas they know where you're tortured, that's pretty heroic. Trump's really savvy, really smart. He said that because he was getting too high in the polls. He was the leader. And he is being directed by top Republican strategists, PR people. That's come out. And Trump is really making me angry. And I told you I got a bad feeling about him. He's super smart. He knows exactly what he's doing. And so just watch. He gets back in the lead again. He'll do more of the same. On purpose. He knows all about McCain. McCain is well known for all of his criminal activity. And Trump has to be watched very, very closely. So I'm going to be getting to all of that. Let me just hit this now and then to your calls because it's so important. I mentioned it earlier. CBS News, we have a link to it with the maps up on Infowars.com. USGS scientists say major quake on Hayward Fault expected any day now. The fault that produced a 4.0 magnitude earthquake in Fairmont early Tuesday morning is expected to produce a major earthquake any day now, and Bay Area residents should be prepared, a U.S. Geological Survey scientist said. And here's the issue. The only area, and we've had seismologists and experts on, but it's mainstream news. It's not debated. The only area of the Pacific Rim Ring of Fire that has not triggered in the last 8 years since the tsunami started that hit Japan and other countries since we've seen all this devastation, just unparalleled earthquakes from India to Pakistan to you name it, just the entire ring of fire that rings the Pacific Ocean. The west coast of Latin America, the west coast of the United States, Canada, the east coast of Asia, Europe, Russia, unprecedented. And that trigger area from the Baja up to Seattle has not triggered. And there are more than 50 major points on that area from northern Mexico up into Canada that have not triggered yet. And so it's just going to go off like a string of firecrackers. And when it does, it's 2 years overdue. 2 years overdue. And talk about sitting on top of a time bomb. And by the way, you notice that the Ring of Fire extends inland over to the area of Yellowstone underground with those plates. And it is rising and lowering dramatically in different areas of the park. And that is a super caldera, a super volcano. The last time it erupted, it covered 80% of what is the United States in molten ash. So we talk about the biggest threats humanity poses to humanity in a report with Rex Jones yesterday, but what about the biggest threats we're not in control of? And then you get the Pentagon jacking around with seismic weapons they've got, which are declassified, that they have them. The specifics are classified. And just who knows what's going on. Basically, they have been testing magnetic systems out that are just like the movie The Core. And other films, you know, where it shows the military in Alaska testing stuff and then it ends up causing a huge earthquake. That's what Secretary of Defense William Cohen talked about in 1997 in the Army Times. He admitted that we have earthquake weapons, tectonic weapons, and so do other governments. And then you've got all the geoengineering. I saw a comment yesterday on Rex's video from YouTube going, of course Jones refuses to cover geoengineering and is covering it up because I didn't put it in that report. Oh, come on. When are you going to cover the Federal Reserve being private, Jones? I mean, I just love these straw man arguments. When are you going to cover the Federal Reserve, buddy? I've actually had people in person confront me, and I'm like, what? Are you kidding? When are you going to defend the Second Amendment, traitor? You'd be like, I mean, I guess mental midgets do that where they like build a straw man or they tune in for an hour and don't hear you cover something. And so they don't know you covered it the day before. It's just bizarre. Okay, that's some of the news. I want to go to your phone calls now. We're going to go to Cameron. We're going to go to Alex. We're going to go to Chris, Brandon, Christopher, and others. Cameron, thanks for holding her on the air.
Hi, it's Cameron. I'm from Orange County, California. And, first of all, I wanted to say that I know, like, we're portrayed as a bunch of lunatics out here, but there's, like, so many of us that are awake. It's not even funny. Are you there? I'm sorry. I can't even hear anything.
Absolutely. I mean, I'll interrupt you if you want.
Oh, no. That's okay. I didn't know if you knew this, but what's his name? His name's Tony Muhammad from the Louis Farrakhan. He represents him on the West Coast. He's been at like a couple different rallies for the SB-277 and said that he's going to address it in the Million Man March coming up in October. And also they're supposed to march to the CDC headquarters in Georgia afterwards, to talk about this, and said that they're not going to let this go through. They're really all against this whole thing too. And I'm not a big fan of that or anything, but whatever it takes.
No, you're a great call because that's why I love taking calls. You bring up something I meant to say weeks ago and never covered. And I wasn't trying to be smart mouth. People always start talking, and then if I don't interrupt them, then they say, hey, are you there? And then I'm bad about interrupting, so I try to not interrupt. But long story short, the Nation of Islam puts out a lot of really great information. They're a paradox, because Louis Farrakhan says some really horrible things, like blaming Asians because they come and build stores in the black community. Well, build your own stores. And then Louis Farrakhan says, no, we should shop at our own stores and build our community up. I'm all for that. I don't think it's racist to support your community and try to empower yourselves by shopping locally. shopping with local farmers, but also if you're in a depressed black area, you should try to support black businesses. So they say, support your local businesses, create your own community, don't take the inoculations, they're putting poison in it. I've read their Trumpet newspaper. It's full of so much good stuff. Louis Farrakhan talks about the government shipping drugs in. That's true. But then he'll get up and just really push for racial confrontation when that's exactly what the globalists want. I mean, I hear stuff out of Farrakhan's mouth that I know George Soros is basically financing other people to say. And I know George Soros is really a bad guy. And I really know most white people are not racist. They might be uncomfortable and scared of black people because of the media, just like black folks get scared of cops because of the media, even though statistically you're not any more likely to be attacked if you're black than if you're white. I do think black people get pulled over more. That's been statistically proven. So there is profiling going on. But it's like this lady. They finally released the whole squad car video. And I appreciate your call. Great point, Cameron. Of this black lady who put out a video of herself up in Illinois saying, I'm depressed, I'm freaked out, I'm having panic attacks, I'm freaking out. Well, the state police pull her over in Texas, and the guy writes her a warning, and she just blows up at him, won't shut up. He says, okay, get out of the car. Then she starts running around, freaking out. He tries to put her in handcuffs. She resists him, and then she goes and dies in police custody. Now, do some of these departments beat people to death in the jail? Absolutely. It goes on. It's terrible. But if you watch the state policeman, I mean, he's a good cop, a good trooper compared to some of the ones I've seen. And the media, and they're having marches and everything else saying she was murdered. And then it turns out that she had serious psychiatric problems and had a victim psychology. And I'm not saying this is what happened, but I'd say about an 80% chance she did kill herself as a whole way to make herself the victim because she was already suicidal. But I'm not going to play the whole 14 minutes. The raw video is on Infowars.com. I sent it to Nico. So I don't know if they posted it. We should post it. But video released of traffic stop in Sandra Bland case. And, I mean, she is just freaking out on the trooper. On and on and on. And the average out-of-control cop would have tasered her right away. I mean, compared to a lot of cops where they just punch you in the face for no reason, they need to be arrested. But in her case, I think she committed suicide. That's what my gut tells me. It's a tragedy. My son, Rex Jones, was in studio live with us for the first time ever. He's done some tape reports over the last 3 years. And my daughters are here with me today at work. We're not going to show them on TV. But they wanted to come in the studio and be a little part of it. So this is their maiden voyages. I love you, girls. So there are those little sweethearts. Thanks, guys. All right, there they go. They're looking through the window in here into the studio. And, you know, that's really what it's all about. The globalists wish that, which they're out of the room. Go ahead and close the door. Love you. The globalists wish they'd never been born. Well, guess what? They were. And they've never had any vaccines. They eat non-GMO almost all the time. It's hard to not let them eat some because it's everywhere. They drink non-fluoridated water. They're healthy. They're happy. They're full of vibrant energy. And I just thank God for them. And that's the reason I'm not backing down is my children. Some people would say back down, go along for your kids. There is no future for the species if we don't stop the globalists. It's that simple. And the Nation of Islam's got it right. Don't take the vaccines. And we need to organize these different communities around, hey, don't abort your babies, black people, white people, anybody. All lives matter. Something the governor got in trouble for. We need to organize around realizing the vaccines are social experiments. We're being manipulated. We're being dumbed down. The IQ is physically dropping. They've been caught putting cancer viruses in them. This isn't rhetoric. This is real. This is epic, legendary, covert soft kill going on. And if it ever starts to come out, that's it for the New World Order. I see a black family, a, quote, mixed family, white family, Hispanic family, walking down the street, Asians, whatever. I want them to be healthy, successful, happy. I want to see their art. I want to read their literature. I want to listen to their music. I want to go eat their food. I like diversity. I like different cultures. I like the mix of cultures. I believe in people. That's what makes me so mad when I see sicko globalists sitting there trying to get us all fighting with each other when they're preying on everyone. I mean, a perfect microcosm of this is Planned Parenthood. Tens of millions aborted at their hands. The Eugenics League basically changed their name to Planned Parenthood. They helped found and fund fascist movements, the Nazi Party. You can read their quotes, and they are worshipped as the very oxygen of liberal trendiness. And then behind closed doors, they're like, yeah, we want to kill blacks. Yeah, we sell body parts. Yeah, we... I mean, all these tapes have been coming out for years. And they're going to release more tapes now. They're warning Planned Parenthood, the new racist ones. Well, you know what? It's all racist against innocent children. It devalues human life to say they're black babies or they're white babies. But see, now, that politician running for president, O'Malley, he said, no, you know what? Black lives, white lives, all lives. That's a classical liberal statement. No, and they're like, no, no, because it's racially based. But then it doesn't even do anything for that race-based group. It's the Federal Reserve screwing over black people. It's NAFTA and GATT screwing over black people. It's open borders screwing over black people. It's the vaccines, the fluoride. And guess what? It's screwing everybody else over. And when you make it about one group, you limit the real scope. All right, I'm going to stop ranting. Alex in Michigan, thanks for holding. You're on the air worldwide.
Hey, Alex, how's it going, bro?
Good, God, my friend. Go ahead.
And your family.
God bless you.
I just had a question. Wanted to talk to you about a few things going on. I like the previous caller from Michigan. There's a lot of spy planes here in Kalamazoo, over my area at least. There was a chemtrail operation, too, and now it's all cloudy out. It was perfectly sunny when I woke up. But I had a question. I'm trying to start up a small business. What's the best way to do that?
You know, you've got to study your local market and see what is going to work best. But a lot of it's marketing. One of the most successful things I've seen, if you're in the right area, is mowing people's lawns. And then once you make enough money, get people under you, have quality, respond to people well, customer service, and you'll have 40 people working for you in a couple of years. And you'll have the headache of dealing with it, and it's a lot of work. But I know people that have lawn care crews and that have gardening crews, people that make more money than I do. Upper middle class, living in mansions, basically living in, you know, 6-7 bedroom houses with two boats and a big pool, and their kids all going to college, and they own a lawn company. I mean, I know so many people that own pool companies, lawn companies, service companies, that do construction companies, that do quality work, who are doing very, very well. But I mean, who needs to be rich? I mean, the big thing is just being self-sufficient. And so I mean, Kalamazoo is a beautiful area. A lot of the Dutch folks up there take care of themselves. But, you know, I'd have to be specific in that area to know what to tell you, my friend. But there's just a lot of things out there to do. We're going to come back with more calls. Stay with us. The Empire. Imagine what's going to happen out on the West Coast if another big earthquake hits along these fault lines where they built nuclear power reactors and we get a new Fukushima-type situation. In fact, up on Infowars.com, we have some of the photos that have gone viral in Japan of mutated daisies. And we have mutated butterflies and record numbers of children just collapsing dead of heart failure. That's what happens with children and radiation. And their answer is just to say, oh, the radiation's safe, it's no problem. Why would they build 6 reactors on a fault line in a tsunami area and then say it was impossible for it to melt down, and then 5 of the 6 reactors got damaged, 3 of them completely blew up? Then they covered that up. I went and looked at the design of the MOX reactor, the big one that was plutonium and uranium that blew up, the second one to explode with a hydrogen explosion. And I went and looked at the design of it and blueprints that were online, and then I blew up the video. We put out articles back when it happened 4 years ago and said, it appears that the entire reactor was shot hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of yards into the air. We even measured how high the communication towers were around there. We could see it was three times higher. And I said, it looks like it may have ejected what appears to be fuel rods up to a mile away. 3 years after the New York Times published a report where the Japanese government admitted that fuel rods were ejected a mile and a half away, and indeed it had blown completely up. It had achieved fission, a small atomic explosion, and had shot them further than I even thought. Now, I'm not bragging. It's just that the media knew what they were seeing. Physicists knew what they were seeing. Nuclear engineers knew what they were seeing. I had nuclear and chemical engineers on saying basically the same thing. But where is the survival instinct of the species to not even care about this? Now there's triple the radiation in the Northern Hemisphere than there is in the Southern Hemisphere. What's going on? Why is there a death wish by the elite? Because if they don't care about little babies or veterans, they don't care about themselves. That's why I was haunted yesterday and last night and currently by the video of the Planned Parenthood National Council director, the head of their council, the head of their board, haggling over baby organs. And I think about the denial where 20 years ago on air, I would talk about China selling political dissidents organs when it was in the British news. And U.S. news would write articles saying I was lying. The State Department put out a report about 14 years ago dispelling conspiracy theories that there was an organ trade in China. The Chinese government advertises they sell political dissidents' organs. It's in Japanese newspapers, public executions, where they then announce that minutes after they're killed, they have their organs taken. Now they have mobile execution vans, 14 per major city, where they keep you alive and do a vivisection, removing your heart finally and sucking your blood out so they can take each organ properly on the runway, pack them in ice and fly them out. People say, why are you covering this macabre? Because I couldn't get people to admit it when it was in foreign news 18, 19, 20 years ago. How am I going to get people to admit they're putting cancer viruses in the vaccines and fluoride in the water? I mean, Harvard admits it's lowering our IQs over 10 points. They admit it's giving us bone cancer. Their own scientists aren't bad at the FDA. They say take it out, but the elites say no. But we've reached a breaking point where so many lawsuits have been filed, they're now cutting the amount of fluoride in the water by half. My point is, we're so close to beating these people, I can feel it. We've known for decades that Planned Parenthood sells baby parts. The problem is, chopping them up, they have trouble keeping the organs, so they mainly sell them for blood product, for stem cell research, and for cosmetics, the collagen. But now we can force a debate about this. Now we can admit it's going on. Notice the first week this came out, they had a whole bunch of publications just say it wasn't real. Then, when it turned out it was real, MSNBC said, big deal. It's research. And now the videos are going to be released. They were smart with them talking about getting rid of the minorities and how they're a big problem. And you're going to see the real face of MSNBC and CNN. I predict they're going to ignore it no matter how bad it is because they can't face it. A vampire can't face high noon out in the town square. That's all I want to do is haul these people out of their pits where they want to hide. They want to creep out at night politically. They want to have their way with us in the dead of night. No, you're going to have it out in front of God and everybody. We're going to drag you out of your crypts right up in the middle of the town square, and everything you've been doing is going to be brought out in the open because you love hurting innocent people. You enjoy it. You're ghouls. All these allegories, all these legends have a basis in reality. The Greeks, 2,500 years ago in major cities, would have vampire hunting days. Look this up. And they would go out into the crypts, into the caves, into the areas, and it was mainly psychopathic, mentally ill people who would creep around at night and grab folks and drag them off and eat them. In major Greek cities, they had psychopaths that would that believed they were vampires that would do this, and people would go out and hunt them and kill them. Now these people run Planned Parenthood. And if you go out to an abortuary and they know you're going to be there, people in black will arrive with totally white skin. If they're black, they look like vampires. They're totally light. And they just and they literally show up and start going, Satan, because that's who they are. And I know it sounds over the top, but I'm telling you, folks, I'm telling you, they're possessed demons. And people over at the White House run, you know, publications, go ahead and make your jokes all day. People know what I'm saying is true. Look at the Texas House. I talked about it yesterday. Last year, they're trying to pass a bill, or 2 years ago, the last session, they're back in session now, they were trying to ban partial birth abortion, but those are the prizes where they get all the organs. You know, babies that could live. And just spontaneously, dozens of women started hissing, I love Satan, hell Satan, and sticking their tongues out and hissing like snakes. I don't know what's going on, folks, but I can't handle it anymore. These people literally crawl out from under rocks. They run and hide in trash cans right in front of you. Why are we ruled by a bunch of trash can-dwelling vampires? The one guy that grabbed my microphone and attacked me and all that literally had the whitest skin I've ever seen. Everybody said that guy looks like a ghoul, like a vampire, and he wasn't acting. He was bumping into people. It was like he wasn't even alive, and he was just had this satanic look in his eye. He's going, well, I mean, what do you expect to be attracted to a place where they're butchering babies while we were outside, women were driving in to have their babies killed? So, of course, showing up to defend it is the demons. Don't you understand? It's not a game. I don't know whether it's interdimensional creatures, whether it's demons, whether it's some kind of mental illness, whatever, they're still a demon. Whatever it is, they got to be dealt with. And in ancient Greece, those folks would be hanging out in the caves and, you know, I guess they had, I just can't even handle anymore. Yeah, he had like green skin. My dad calls those people glow-in-the-dark people. And I've seen this over and over again. Our enemies literally have green skin. I mean, they love death. They love their father. And so, good, go have death. Go jump off a cliff. Don't hurt anybody else. Just get out of our way. We want to get off the planet. We want space bases. We want clean energy. We want to maintain human dignity. We want to maintain goodness. We want to be honorable. We don't like the devil. We don't want to be around you. I'm sorry, let's go to calls. Got Froggo in England and Chris in Georgia and Brandon and Christopher. Let's go to Froggo in England. I mean, I don't mean this show to turn into a complete preacher fest. I'm just so freaked out. I'm just telling you what's on my mind. Go ahead, Froggo. You're on the air.
Hi, preacher.
Welcome. Your Skype or whatever it is breaking up. Go ahead.
Oh, hang on. I'll get closer to the source. Any better?
It's okay. Go ahead.
Right. They warned me this might happen. Right then.
I'm going to put you on hold while you try to fix it. We're going to come back to you because I want to hear from you. Chris in Georgia, you're on the air.
Hey, how's it going?
All right, brother, go ahead.
So, interesting thing happened this morning. I thought the whole Marine Corps thing was like the just one cracked out meth head that decided to go shoot Marines. But then when you guys reported that it was nationwide threats or whatever, I decided to go to my local recruiter's office this morning. And so I show up and I'm not outwardly showing any weapons or anything like that. And then there were some Marines outside. And I asked them if they'd seen any Oath Keepers. They put out a national call or anybody like that. And they're like, yeah, one person or something. And the guy told me the head Marine recruiter told me that the Marine Corps Recruiting Command put out a directive today that if anybody shows up armed to protect the Marines, that the Marine recruiter in charge has to call the local police, file a police report, call the Army Corps of Engineer and turn those people into them for trespassing on federal property with guns, and press charges, and there's a bunch of other paperwork that they have to do. So the Marine Corps is pushing back real hard when, at least at a local level here in Georgia, it shows on the local news, you know, the Marine recruiters or whatever branch, the recruiters coming out and taking pictures with everybody, and they appreciate it. But at a federal level, they're pushing back really hard. I had a few opinions about it, but
this is huge news, and I believe you sound very credible. The Marine Corps, I guess, under Obama, thinks it owns these Marines and thinks they're allowed to just set them out there as sitting ducks. We've confirmed threats and, pouring in all over the country, especially. But if it's a shopping center and it's an open carry state, and if the owner of the shopping center is cool with you sitting across in the grass, you know, or whatever, and protecting it, then I don't see how that could happen. But that's amazing. Don't even threaten them with trespass. I guess they want to get these patriots in jail as fast as possible. That is just incredible. Was the Marine, was the head Marine that you talked to upset by this, or did he love it?
No, he was not. Well, he was real, you know, I guess you see it a lot in federal employees.
Matter of fact.
Really don't care. Yeah, he was like, you know what, I asked him, I said, hey, do you mind these people coming out? Do you appreciate it? Do you not want them here? And he was like, you know what? I just don't want to have to call the police, and I really don't want to do paperwork. He said, if anybody's going to come shoot, they're going to come shoot. So he,
what a cowardly, resigned attitude.
Yeah. And, you know, I have a couple feelings about it. At least at a federal level, there is a possibility that the next crisis could be averted by Americans carrying weapons, as opposed to the next crisis used to stop Americans carrying weapons.
You just said it. They want more of these to happen so they can blame the Second Amendment. They have a major stake in demonizing common sense. They don't want a patriot to stop a crazy Islamicist. And so that's, they're already upset about Garland. They're upset by the response of citizens wanting to protect these facilities. And you're absolutely right. Go ahead.
Let's spitball it for a second. What happens if it were a nationwide threat? There was another attack, and an Oath Keeper, somebody stopped it. What would happen is...
That makes the Oath Keepers heroes. That makes the Second Amendment a hero. They don't want that.
And even further, when was the last time Americans walked away from their you know, good employment, good, hardworking Americans, dropped what they were doing, and picked up a gun for a common cause? Because I can tell you...
1776.
On American soil. That's right. And if that were to happen... And soccer moms and businessmen and college students all showed up at recruiting centers and National Guard centers, at least outside metropolitan areas like Atlanta, you would have thousands of armed people easily, quickly. I mean, within an hour. And what would those people think? They would immediately understand the power that they hold. And, you know, even if nothing happened, okay? The next national emergency that happened, would those people say, where's the National Guard? No. They'd say, well, hell, we can all go down there. We have more people than the National Guard.
You need to have your own radio show, bro. The way you just crystallized that, boiled it down so simply, succinctly, with pure rational knowledge, and then I'm up here bumbling around trying to explain it. Exactly. That's why they don't want the troops armed themselves, because it's this idea that, well, then citizens can be their own security, and then that ends the need to take all of our freedoms to counter these manufactured threats. We've got to take this little piece that you just put out live and post it with a title saying... The mystery of why they want the recruiting centers disarmed, revealed, and explain why this could become 1776 Part 2. It all began in Michoacan, one state in Mexico, where just a few farmers fought back against having their employees killed at lime farms. And then that spread all over the state, then to other states, till the army came in and disarmed them. Because the army works with the drug dealers openly in Mexico. And it's the same story. Just one person stands up and then defeats the enemy or even is defeated, it doesn't matter. That act of defiance is infectious, and they don't want that humanity there. It's why they're getting rid of contact sports. It's why they're getting rid of dodgeball, why they're getting rid of tag, while they're arresting kids for their free speech, is to just create total ninnies that will submit to anything and everything for total enslavement. So, Chris, excellent points. I really appreciate you doing that. And you're a citizen journalist. You ought to go back with a camera and see if they'll talk to you, because we can't do it all. We need articulate, smart folks like you to be out there in the info war. So great job, Chris. You took the first step, went out and talked to folks, discovered huge news. We're going to get on this case now, finding out if you're in the military and you have one of these orders and it's not classified, telling you to call the police on folks that are coming to try to give you security. Please send that info to showtips@infowars.com. We are all in this together. We're all on Team Humanity. Break the trance. Pull back. The globalists are a scientific, technological group of parasites using high-tech systems of control on the population. They are the vampires, the social vampires, the psychic vampires, the cultural vampires, waging war on anything free and independent. And anything that is self-replicating that they don't control. It is a great monopoly that they are bringing to the fore. And when you pull back from that, with all these mounting problems, you can see them engaged in classical divide and conquer. Are we smart enough to transcend this? Because once you know you're under attack, you're not worried about looking cool before your neighbors anymore. You're not feeling insecure because you don't have the new truck. All the Madison Avenue, PR, Wall Street, Hollywood brainwashing. You realize it's about taking care of yourself, your family. It's about being strong. It's about being independent. It's about having a mission-based life. That's what's fulfilling. Third hour, jam-packed with the news coming up. We'll go to Brandon in Alabama, Christopher in Colorado, John in Wyoming, Mike, and so many others. But I wanted to bring Weldon Henson in here briefly because we have a great sponsor. Boy, I've sure been enjoying the firearms that I've gotten from him. HDfirearms.com. That's Head Down Firearms. They have super high quality 223s, 308, you name it. It's called 556, technically, in the 223, that are guns that would be $3,000 or $1,500. Guns that would be $1,500 or $900. And even lower. But I never really talked about everything else they've got at HDfirearms.com. You can just call them. They can ship the gun right to a dealer in your area or ask your dealer to order some of them so you can see them there. They're patriots. They're involved in the Second Amendment. They're involved nationally lobbying to defend the Second Amendment. This is the type of firearms company you want to support. Plus, it's the highest quality. And they support this broadcast. It's a 360 win. But separately, they've got a bunch of super high quality customization services, holsters, accessories. Weldon Henson, tell us about some of the great accessories available at HDfirearms.com.
Well, the important thing to remember is that if you're not in the market to buy a brand new rifle, you have an AR-15, you have an AR-10 platform 308 rifle. They've got everything you need to upgrade it. Buy a new part, buy a new trigger, buy a new muzzle brake, buy a new handrail. It's all an upgrade for your rifle because these are all superior top-of-the-line quality products made in America.
That's another point. And I mean, there's literally, it's got to be close to 100 different products. Plus, they don't call it a ghost or a stealth. They use the Special Forces term for being able to buy most of the firearm except for the lower receiver. Tell folks about their low-profile series.
They just came out with these, what we call Project Low Pro do-it-yourself rifle kits. Basically, you buy this whole kit. It's got everything you need besides the lower receiver. It's up to you how you want to get your lower receiver. There's all certain ways to do that. But you basically get a brand new rifle right here. Save money. Do it yourself. Put it together. Find your own lower receiver so it's not traceable. Whatever you got to do. But this is a complete package, and it's top-of-the-line quality.
So it's not confiscatable because we know they're doing that unlawfully now. They're especially announced they're going after the Social Security recipients. If you take a automatic transfer, they're going to claim that you've advocated your responsibility as a fiduciary and take your guns.
Also with disabled veterans, they're trying to take their guns as well.
Absolutely. I've been telling you, the main assault on the Second Amendment is here. Get these high-quality firearms before the next rush starts. Or they may just confiscate guns by stealth and we just give up. I mean, I guess that because we're here Ringing the alarm, hdfirearms.com. Weldon, do five more minutes with us. We're going to come back and take calls. But I want you to talk about some of the other accessories and their new 308 that I tell you is a true beauty.
Well, that one came in yesterday. I was actually pretty
Thank
jealous
you
about
for listening
that.
Well, we're
going to
go to break.
Yeah.
We knew it was coming. Incremental gun confiscation. It's how tyrants always operate. They target the old, the vets. They've already been using a VA system to confiscate guns with no evidence, no reason. Now they admit in the LA Times they're moving with that model. We had the reporter on yesterday that broke it all at the Daily Caller 2 weeks ago. And they're now coming after 4+ million retirees that they say fit the bill to have their guns taken. Weldon, now is the time for people to get accessories. Now is the time for people to get backups, to get extra parts. Tell us more about the low-pro, low-profile series from HDFirearms.com and some of the other accessories available.
Well, this is an important thing to have. You know, this is untraceable. Anybody can get this kit right here. You don't have to go through a federal firearms license place. You can have it shipped right to your house.
This is what the traders have been trying to shut down.
Absolutely, absolutely. So you basically have everything you need besides a lower receiver, because that's what's traceable, that's what's serialized, and that's what the federal government's after. But you can get this right here. Get your own lower receiver any way you want. There's different programs. All you got to do is your own research, and you can find out how to get a lower receiver so that you can put it on this. Maybe you already have a lower receiver from an AR from way back that you just don't quite use anymore. It's old, something like that. You can throw it on this. You basically have a brand new rifle, and you saved money by putting it together yourself and buying this kit right here, which is cheaper than the actual rifle.
And they've got the highest quality barrels, the highest quality triggers. We're not just saying that. Go look at the third-party reviews. This is not hype when we talk about their 5.56. Now, tell them about the new rifle they're producing that's getting amazing reviews. And then I just got one, this 308.
Yes, that is very...
Arcadius.
That's very exciting. They just came out with their own line of AR-10 platforms, which is basically an AR-15, but instead of it being a 5.56, it shoots a 308 round, which I know you personally like shooting a 308.
I like them both. I mean, just to be clear, they've always, for years, been making this for the big manufacturers, the high-end. They're just now not private labeling. They're putting out their own guns.
Yes. Well, the one they sent you, I'm actually jealous of, is a beautiful gun. It's set up and configured for long-range shooting, marksmanship-type things.
It's right here in front of us. Just the scope alone is something to snuggle with.
Yeah, it's a Vortex 4x16 scope, which you can get at Head Down as well, their distributor. And I think things for people to remember is that if you want a 308, you don't have to get the 18-inch barrel. You don't have to get the 22-inch barrel. You don't have to get it set up for marksmanship. You can get one with a 16-inch barrel that's set up for more of an assault weapon type, you know, configuration. So anything you want, people, just call Head Down. You can get anything you want made there. And any configuration you might want on your rifle, they're able to do that. And they have 100% perfect customer service ratings there.
It really is amazing. And again, they support the broadcast. So this is where folks should get their high-quality 5.56 or 308 or their basically stealth low-pro type systems, triggers, accessories, you name it, just the highest quality, cutting-edge, battle-tested. A lot of major units are actually using this in special ops. So they're continually getting feedback and upgrading what they're doing.
When you buy these products, whether it's the rifle or just some accessories, it's superior craftsmanship and it's competitive pricing. You can't get these type of products anywhere cheaper. You know what I mean? They basically have the most competitive pricing and it's superior craftsmanship and it's all made in America. Two things right here that I have that's simple that you could upgrade your AR-15 or your AR-10 at home. It's a PVX muzzle brake. It's one of the top-of-the-line things you can buy for your rifle. Helps with the muzzle rise, gives it more accuracy. Simple. Put it on right there. It works. This is a head-down developed and designed single-stage trigger. You can get it in a 3.5-inch pound or 4-inch pound trigger. And I dropped one of these in one of my old AR-15s that I use as what you call a truck gun. You just beat it up. I've had it forever. I also have a head-down rifle, which I love even more. But I dropped this in it. It shot like a dream. Just dropping this trigger in.
Bottom line, it's not just firearms, a ton of accessories, very affordable, and it supports the info war. If you're not shopping at hdfirearms.com, you're not helping the info war. I mean, this is a win-win. Thank you all for your support. Check them out today. Thank you, Weldon. Well, if this music isn't fitting for Planned Parenthood caught in the second video with their national director, the chairperson of their board of directors, talking about how she wants Lamborghinis and wants the lowest prices on baby parts for sale, while she drinks wine and cackles and looks like a vampire queen, it just illustrates the truth is stranger than fiction. And it's everything I've been telling you. You got to get out of these fake churches, get out of your houses, turn off the American Idol or whatever's on TV now, and go out and engage the globalist, and you will run into the lowest forms of scum. See, you just want to go have your own life and don't want to run anything. They do, and they're in charge. And now they're announcing they want to get rid of our free speech. Now they're announcing that our kids belong to them. No, no, no. Yeah, if the cops pull you over and they're not trying to take you to a FEMA camp in the future, it's best to just comply, even if you disagree with the unconstitutional laws or whatever. Because the average cop isn't a terrorist, isn't a bad person. And if you get in a fight with them, you're going to end up going to jail, getting killed. Even if you kill them, they're going to hunt you down. It's pointless. But when it comes to not complying with the schools trying to forcibly inoculate your kids, when it comes to the system trying to put fluoride in your water, when it comes to the system trying to bankrupt our dollars, trying to get rid of cash, and trying to get rid of our jobs, that's the real assault. So they want us to instead, with the Ford Foundation and others funding it, and Soros, make the whole revolution about rioting and attacking local police, because that'll just destabilize things further. Now, at the bottom of the hour, I'm going to go into a complete news conniption. There's probably, let's not exaggerate, probably 100 articles I haven't gotten to. I probably covered 50 already. And I said I'd get back into this big Wired magazine article about, well, we can't let the public have the life extension. Who will get it? So there's that whole debate. And by forcing a debate about this, it's the beginning of the end of the globalist using national security and global security to keep all this stuff secret for themselves. So that's why we're here exposing it. Just like 4+ million in the FBI memo are set to now have their guns taken. And they're using the VA program of secrecy to take veterans' guns now for Social Security recipients. And I can't believe I'm not even more freaked out. We should send out Jakari Jackson or Leanne McAdoo or Darren McBreen or John Bowne or Rex Jones, whoever, one of our reporters, to go out in Austin and say, hey, now here's the FBI memo, here's the Daily Caller article. It says that if you take a money transfer, a direct wire of your Social Security, that means you must be inept. You're incompetent to own guns. No judge, no jury. The 68 Gun Control Act says you're a felon or mentally incompetent. It's not in the law. They're just doing it. That's why it's so dangerous. It's such a big deal. ATF works with FBI and VA to get veterans' guns taken away. I told you it was coming. And the old people are dependent on that check, so they think they're going to call them up and go, how's the ATF? And I've had the ATF call me before. This is how it works. We'd like you to come down to our office, and we'll drop by over there. Want to discuss a firearm with you? And then the ATF shows up. I was not rude. And I was like, well, ATF busy these days? We're the BATF. I was like, whoa, dude, don't bow up to me. Well, why you, and they had like some other guy casing around the parking lot while this was going on with these vests on with their guns already. And another time at the gun show, the ATF walked up to me. So I later talked to him. I was like, oh, that's the ATF. And I was like, Jones, we're so sick of you. And they had some other guy pop up and go, hey, Alex, buy this gun with me. I don't have my license. Buy it. And I saw ATF. And I was like, I'm not going to do that. And then I looked and it was ATF just waiting. That's what it's like if I go to the gun show. It's just ATF. Just they'll even come over and bow up. Just bizarre behavior. But, you know, agencies, if they begin criminal, they always stay criminal. And the ATF was founded as revenuers who would run around the country. There were several whiskey rebellions, and poor people out west and up north and down south, everywhere, didn't have a lot of ways to make money. And one thing you could do was set up a still and make whiskey or make moonshine. And there were federal and other taxes on it. And people said, we're not going to pay your whiskey tax. And so the revenuers would go around and blow up the stills and arrest the people. I'm not talking about Dukes of Hazzard, folks, or where NASCAR came from liquor running vehicles. I'm talking about, in the 1800s. I'm talking about 200 years ago, 150 years ago. There were huge wars over all of this and insurrections. And the ATF is the oldest federal law enforcement agency. The Texas Rangers is the oldest continual law enforcement agency, if you want to call it that. But for federal, it's the ATF. And a lot of times they would get paid off not to shut down your whiskey or your moonshine, or they just come into your still, kill you, and then sell the liquor themselves. I mean, they are a hardcore group. They bombed Oklahoma City. They were intimately involved. They love going after patriots with no criminal record who are at the gun range, and the AR-15 shoots two rounds, and a tattletale calls them, and they take you to jail, and then they tell the jury, we admit he knew it didn't mean to shoot twice, was still a felony, and that jury will send you up the river with pleasure. I mean, they hate this country. They ship guns into Mexico to blame the Second Amendment. They are a terrorist organization. They torched Waco. I've known good people at the FBI. I've known good people in the state police. I've known good people in the federal marshals, good people in the CIA. The ATF, and I'm sure there are some good people who blew the whistle on Fast and Furious. The point is, the ATF is a incarnate anti-American criminal organization and needs to be abolished before they stage more terror attacks. Brandon in Alabama. Then we'll go to Christopher and John and Mike and others. I'm going to move quick now. I'm going to try my best. Brandon in Alabama, go ahead.
Alex, listen, great show today. And I just wanted to say you have been on a roll today addressing things as far as the spiritual nature of what's going on in our world. And the point is this, is that we have to understand that nothing happens on a world level, on a geopolitical level, that is not being orchestrated and strings being pulled behind the scenes. Do we think it's a coincidence that we see the Pope, the largest of the leader of the world's largest, quote, Christian religion, calling for a one-world government, calling that people who own or manufacture firearms can't be Christians? And you can go on and on down the list.
It's all concerted world government takeover. It's been launched. We're now entering the New World Order. Notice his approval rating has dropped massively with American Catholics. It doesn't matter. He's got a billion third world followers that really think he's their papa when the guy is a snake leading them straight to hell. Is it not biblical?
It is all biblical. It's not a coincidence that 99% of your American megachurch pastors are preaching peace and love and happiness and don't worry about anything because Starbucks is open in the United States and we're sitting in an air-conditioned church.
I'm glad you just said that. I'm glad you just said that because I went and looked it up this morning and checked some major Christian websites and things and Googled some of the sermons of top preachers. In fact, I meant to give this to the reporters, do a story on it. Nothing has been said by Joel Osteen or any of these people. I'll give it to Reverend Graham. He's talked about it, and he's talked about the open borders. None of these so-called preachers, these glitterbugs, have talked about it's all feel good, follow me, and you're going to get rich. No, you're going to get persecuted is what's going to happen. And they're just up there, and I don't want to attack Joel Osteen. He says some things that are good as well, but imagine if Joel Osteen came out against Planned Parenthood. Imagine what that would do. That would save millions of babies, but he won't do it. And I'm not picking on him, just any of them. I went and looked at their websites. Nothing out of these people. They need to get involved for these children. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No, the bottom line is that we are fighting a spiritual battle, Alex. And I know you said you didn't want this to turn into a preacher fest, but if we call ourselves a Christian, we have to wake up and realize that everything in our world is of a spiritual nature. And we have to fight that battle through spiritual eyes. And listen, you're exactly right. The preachers are not addressing this. There are a handful of men, Franklin Graham being one, who are willing to confront the big issues. Jonathan Kahn, Joel Richardson, Carl Gallup, Mark Biltz. Those are all guys that write for World Net Daily. They're addressing these issues, but see, they aren't.
Dobson's been doing it, and he's getting harassed by the IRS and getting their facilities shot up.
That's exactly right. And the bottom line is we have to realize that there are spiritual things going on in this world, and that our battle is not against flesh and blood. They're being played out through people, but there are powers bigger than these people that are orchestrating. And you said it earlier, they are being demonically influenced or possessed or whatever it is. And my word of encouragement to you is, don't worry about it turning into a preacher fest, brother. We have to address things from a spiritual standpoint and a spiritual nature if we call ourselves Christian.
Well, it's just beyond that. The church has been taken over to turn people off from it because it's one of the main command bases of this system. But when you really research this and you go to Bohemian Grove, that's going on right now in California, and you cover all of this, you come to the realization that it is a satanic takeover. And again, I say to the atheists and everybody, call it a sci-fi movie, whatever you want, you know, angels or, you know, demons or aliens or whatever. I don't know. I just know the elite believe they're directed by entities. They believe they're being given all this knowledge. They're doing all this evil stuff. And if you start praying at the Capitol or at a abortuary, people show up in black and start screaming, Hail Satan. I mean, this stuff's going on. And believe me, just imagining, you know, that you're demon-possessed doesn't give you green skin. I mean, when you get around these people, you are looking at another creature. And that's all I can say is I've been around it too much. I'm telling you, folks, it's like Avatar or something. Like there's aliens up there piling these people around. I mean, you know, that's an allegory of Christianity. It's pure evil. You know, Caitlyn Jenner is actually the real El Chapo. The problem is he hasn't actually done the chopping, so I say he's a fraud. But me, I've gone and I've had surgery and I've had these prosthesis ears added. I am now choosing to be transzoological, I believe is the term. I may just have to be transabled and chop my arms and legs off and be known as a biscuit and live in a box, be taken care of. And if you don't accept it, you're hateful. In fact, if you don't adopt my lifestyle and wear dirty brown socks on your ears after you work out, you're a racist. You're a homophobe, you're an anti-zoological phobe, you're a piece of filth. So now, I become my new self. And folks, the proper term is trans species. Paul Watson's decided to become a duck, and you need to honor it and honor the courage, or you're in big trouble. And again, we're not attacking people that have made the decision to change to something else. The point is, it being the number one issue in the world is an example of faux rights versus all of our basic human rights being taken. So one of the crew members, one of the smaller crew members, has decided to go from being a human to a gorilla. And so, Mr. Gorilla, what do you have to say? Okay, there you go, ladies and gentlemen. I'm trying to have some fun. It's such a serious show. That my daughters are here today. They got in the prop room. They even know we had a gorilla outfit. And and she put it on. So I thought of a way to tie that in. And she actually shot that video yesterday, too, at the house. I'd worked out and I'd used dress socks because I didn't have any clean white socks. It was actually hiking socks, brown hiking socks. And I took them off and stuck them on my ears like I was a hound dog. And I was joking around with the girls. And they said, shoot a video, Daddy, shoot a video. And I thought, well, how do I make it political? So that's how things tend to happen around the house. But Alex Jones comes out of the closet. I am a blue tick hound. Actually, a bloodhound. Macadamia nuts, pine nuts. Okay, let's go ahead and take some calls. I apologize. I will just continue with your phone calls. Christopher in Colorado, thanks for holding. You want to talk about transhumanism? Go ahead.
Hey, Alex. Longtime supporter here. So many things to talk about. I mean, there's so many things facing us right now, whether it's the environment, the economy, politics, the attack on civil rights, the attack on sex, the attack on marriage, the attack on the family, whatever. You know, there's so many things. It's hard to choose.
Because engineers get to take all of our money and use it against us, and they control the dinosaur media that puts out the talking points. So this is what it's like to be dominated and run by a bunch of mentally ill people.
Oh, and they just unlimited resources, you know, just unlimited, it's crazy. And this is the first time I've called, and they asked me what I wanted to talk about, and I was thinking, you know, I've been thinking over the past several weeks, like, what is the biggest thing facing us, you know, regardless of everything else that's going on.
I think it's the color of Caitlyn Jenner's lipstick.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's great. That's great. And the whether anything collapses, whether anything, you know, anytime soon, if everything just continues in a normal path of evolution with technology and technology and everything, with computers, in 10, 15 years, it's all going to be exactly the way they want, just based on the evolution of that technology. You can
and they're now telling us
right now.
Exactly. They're going from what was in white papers 30, 40 years ago to what was near reality 10 years ago, but it was all white paper. It wasn't put out popularly, so I sounded crazy covering it, myself and a few others. Now they're all putting it out positively, selling it like it's a good thing, going, we'll be obsolete. We'll be phased out. The robot humans will probably kill all of us. Isn't it wonderful? It's just part of evolution. Get ready to die. They're just mainlining their plan now. I mean, I've got like 9 articles today where they're admitting it.
Oh, yeah. No, and it's like we're waiting for this merging of technology and humans to happen, but in a way, it's already happened. I mean, you walk around anywhere, and everyone is literally merged with, you know, their phones and their computers. I'm not one to take off that list. I mean, without computers, without the internet, we wouldn't even be able to know any of this stuff. So it's kind of a catch 22. But we're already jacked into the Matrix. You know, we carry around bugs with us every day in our pockets, you know, our phones.
And it's just the beginning. And now they say they have the blueprint of total life with the computers and the DNA, and they're just rolling out all these new species. And then they're all abominations. I'd be for it if it worked and was empowering. It dumbs us down, all the technology, makes us sicker, and then creates horrible mutations so that they don't really have control of the global genome. They're just able to mess with it and then create monstrosities. It's exactly what I would expect, again, for the devil to do. It is straight out of the Bible. You know, I should give the number out more than once in the entire show. 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. Frogo in England had a bad digital connection, so he had to hang up. He's called back. Let's try one more time. Then I'm going to go to John, Mike, Adam, and Amy. Then I'm going to hit news and then back to calls. But I've got to try to now move quick through these callers. Frogo, thanks for trying again, from Albion, from Her Britannic Majesty's abode. Welcome, sir.
Hi, Alex, but a bit less of Her Britannic Majesty. I had to restrain myself from using a very rude word.
What? And call her the Grand Witch, or what would you call her?
You're talking. God damn it, I do not like royalty. And this is not what I intended to talk about.
I don't right, either, but I really like your voice. You've got a cool voice. You should do voiceovers.
All right. You want me to do voiceovers? I will.
Just say this is QM74 entering the main quadrant, preparing to drop our payload over C73 Vector. This is.
Well, I didn't get a lot of that, but this is weird. Preparing to drop our payload. Over.
All right, we've got a group of Folk Wolf 109s coming in from the Northeast at about 11 o'clock.
Right, we don't got that much time. Let's quit goofing.
All right, I'll quit screwing around, brother. Go ahead and make your point.
Right then, terminology. It's kind of important stuff because precise choices of words and forms of words have powers, both magical and psychological. Something that's been bothering me for quite a while is the use of the term ISIS for a bunch of CIA-inspired terrorist scum in the Middle East.
Yes.
Now, ISIS is a goddess from ancient Egypt. Fairly nice character, I should know, because I'm a neo-pagan. I'm a member of the Fellowship of Isis, and we are to be a lot less rude than I was about to be when I heard a mention of the Grand Witch, really pissed off about it.
It's not good to call her that.
Yes, it is.
But see, I sense these things. Now, seriously, getting back to this, yes, I would say Isis has the traits that are the opposite of the ancient ISIS, and I think it all is a big Western CIA joke, yes.
There's no doubt about it. I mean, like, when they first announced it on television, what was that, June last year?
Yes.
I immediately thought, there is no way that's an accident. Next thing I thought is, also, there is no way that those people are Muslims, because Muslims would never touch anything pagan. Then, shortly after that, they kind of dropped it. They modified it to ISIL, replacing Syria with the Levant. Now, Obama has had rather a lot to say about them. Notice something. He invariably calls them ISIL. And I know why this is. It's because he doesn't want to call down an extra curse upon himself. Then...
That's interesting, because that would be, if you're into the occult, to be sitting there using that deity's name for another separate group. Obama thinks it's bad luck. I've wondered why he'll never call it IS or ISIS. He does call it ISIL, which is another made-up name. I mean, wow, that's a really interesting theory.
Yeah, I see it as being a little more than a theory. I mean, like, I'm into occult stuff. and I know the things that can happen when you screw around with it. I mean, like, long years ago, let's see, I lived in Earl's Court. I and someone else did a ritual in Notting Dale. When we were finished, I got up, walked home, and there was weird stuff going on behind and around me for... about three quarters of an hour, and then it suddenly clicked that we hadn't closed the circle properly. So right there in Earl's Court Road, fortunately there was no one about the place, I got back into ceremonial mode, closed the circle, and all the weird stuff stopped straight away.
Well, there's no doubt the elite are obsessed with what you'd call ancient pagan rituals, and then they're trying to tell the public, though, that none of this is going on. As a neo-pagan, let me ask your view then. What do you think spiritually is going on this planet?
What's going on this planet? Cosmic struggle between good and evil. what we see is only a little bit of reality. It's a bit like an iceberg. And there is... so much of it. Let's get to the really relevant bit. Mankind, and indeed all life on Earth, has been menaced by demons for, since life on Earth got going. Since the Creator was able to establish this kind of life. The other side, I like to call them tenebrae, which is Latin for darkness. Do not like life. They have been attacking life for millions upon millions of years. And they must regard it as a series of defeats, because there is more and more life. Then, at some point, human life arrived, and they must have thought a load of really unprincipled stuff, because, quite frankly, for all the animal loonies and think what's how nice the world would be if we weren't here, loonies, the fact is that the best form of life anyone can be is human. And if you doubt that, just think how long you could play with your iPhone if you were a frog.
Well, this is what it comes down to, is that, if you look at the cosmology of Christianity or any other ancient culture, kind of with the basic same tenets, that there are interdimensional forces, good and evil. There's the master creating system that gives you all the good things, the life, the regeneration, kinsmanship, all of it. And then you've got forces that love to mutate things, destroy things, and kill things because they hate the creation. And if these demons, as you're calling them, hated what God had created before, then imagine how much they really hate man, which is made in a image of the Creator and able to envision and create. We are light years ahead of the animals in many ways, And so that's what makes the demons so upset and why they want to demonize life and demonize the highest order of life while pulling down that highest order of life to then create the self-fulfilling prophecy that we're trash because the demons cannot destroy the life giver. They can only try to destroy the creation that God made. And that is what you come down to. And then separate that from the occult, which just means hidden for folks that don't know, and Christianity and all of it. The elite at Skull and Bones, at Bohemian Grove, at all these places, they have been given dominion. They pray to the false light, because when you get higher up, they pray to the darkness. Their outside initiates think they're praying to the light, and they're praying to the false light, and at the higher levels, they want to kill everybody, and they're being promised by their God worlds of their own. They're going to merge with the machines and be gods forever if they simply betray God's creation and try to destroy it. And it's heavy information, and you know I've gotten into it a lot because when you look at it, what are the churches are preaching this, but then if you bring science into it and all that's been proven and the sixth sense and everything, oh my God, that's you know that's kooky, that's weird, because they don't want people to know how real it is. What I'm getting at is this. The globalists are occult obsessed. Everything they do is obsessed with it. Obama, all of them. And then, though, their practitioners get out and tell people, there's nothing spiritual, you see everything, you're not conscious, you don't have free will, you're ugly, you're nothing, just don't, just watch what we say, our little limited reality, watch television, watch our spectrum of false reality, their hack of the system, so that they can then go on, in their words, and be the wizards who can operate and live and control the world, they're threatened by any other sentient humans being in there, being able to control reality with what we build and what we do. So they just want us gone so they can play God. Do you agree with that statement?
Yeah, though, a little bit of modification. Till about a month ago, I thought the demons, the globalists, want to kill everyone. And then the horrible truth sank in. No, actually, they want to torment us. They want to kill all humans because humans are able to resist them. They would rather that we come back as inferior forms of life, so identifying as a gorilla is a little bit previous. And then, well, predation can take off like it were it was still in, oh, I don't know, the Jurassic.
Well, it is true. They want to kill us slowly, mutate us, torture us, like a psychopath. And interesting points. I appreciate your call. Call back in again. Thank you, Frogo. Thanks for working so hard to get on the show. They do enjoy taking beautiful, perfect creations of God and making them ugly and failed and have them spew pus out. I mean, they really like that. And they like to torment. People that don't even believe in God, people that don't even are total atheists, they take DMT, which I don't take hard drugs. I haven't taken, don't take illegal drugs. But they take it and they go, oh my God, I believe in God now. You know, I was on a spaceship for 100 years with demons torturing people. And then you go give it to somebody from India, somebody from Mexico, somebody from Germany, somebody who's an atheist. And they either, it seems the smarter you are, the more hellish it is, people I've talked to. I mean, if you're really smart and tuned in, you see it and it's like, oh my God. And it's just unbelievable hell that's going on because you're tuned into their level. And if you're kind of stupid and trendy, it's like all wonderful and happy and they want to be your friend. Again, I don't know. Let's say it's not real. In a Carl Jung way, it's a shared human archetype. What is that programming that you take DMT that you release a little bit of during deep sleep, during vivid dreams, and a ton of when you die? That's why your life does flash before you. I've talked to a lot of folks, family, been there when people die, and the last day while they're dying, it's incredible. Everything's replaying back. They're recounting things. Their memory's perfect. Their eyes just fire up. That's because DMT's starting to be slowly released, and then when they die, a bunch of it's released, and your whole life flashes before you. Well, you take that stuff, and I've talked to people that have taken it. In fact, somebody very close that I wish would go on air and talk about it. And it was like an eternity on a prison space station with demons doing brain surgeries, torturing people. And let me tell you, the person said it was real. And I talk to other people, and they go, yeah, that's what you see. I mean, folks, and that's what all the ancient cultures talked about, what they put on cave walls, what the Aztecs kind of bought into it and started doing. I mean, it is just whacked out, folks, whacked out. Call it evil energy, whatever you want. It's imposing itself on the planet. It wants to chop babies up. Why are we letting it? See, I said I'd take calls, and I took that one call that was very interesting, and now there's other calls. And John in Wyoming, thanks for holding. You're a trooper. You're on the air.
Yeah, Alex, I need to remind all of your listeners that tomorrow the House is voting on that Monsanto Protection Act. It's House Resolution 1599. And if this thing passes, now you need to call your congressman today, people, because they're voting on this tomorrow. If this thing passes, then your individual states will not be able to require food processors to label their foods. Are they wholesome and natural, or are they genetically modified? And we have to put a stop to it. They bought out some congressman from Kansas. I think his name is Paul Amaro. And this guy is introducing the legislation. It's going to be voted on tomorrow in the House. And if it passes, you can say goodbye to wholesome and natural foods and hello to nothing but GMOs.
Love taking calls, John. As you brought up something we covered earlier in the week, we've never seen such Facebook censorship. That we try to post articles about this, they just shut it down and censor it. And you're absolutely right. Imagine they want to force GMO, known to kill honeybees, known to kill the bugs that eat it, known to cause serious gut problems on us, and not even let it be labeled and not even let Monsanto be sued.
It's House Resolution 1599. Now, if you have a minute, I'll tell you a few more things about John McCain. The so-called hero John McCain tried to shut down all the gun shows. He was co-sponsor of McCain-Feingold. He was co-sponsor with Ted Kennedy on that Shamnesty bill. He signs on to Kyoto, which will cost us an extra 60 cents a gallon.
He met with the ISIS commanders and helped fund the Free Syrian Army that's now Al-Qaeda running around.
He says we'll be in Iraq another 50 to 100 years. He's a decades-long member of the CFR. He opposed the Bush tax cuts. He was heavily involved in the SNL scandals in the late 80s. And in order to buy a simple bottle of vitamins, he wants you to be required to get a doctor's prescription to buy a simple bottle of vitamins, yet you and I, being adults, can walk into any store in the country and buy alcohol or tobacco, which can kill us without a doctor's prescription.
Incredible.
But McCain doesn't want you to be able to buy any vitamins without a doctor's prescription.
Hey, can I say this, John?
John is a Manchurian candidate.
He is a Manchurian candidate. Can we hire you as a correspondent?
Why not?
You have a great voice, and you're even smarter, and I just am so honored. I'm not kissing your butt. It's true. You guys sit on hold forever. I'm up here babbling about space platforms and demons, and you're just so smart, nailed everything on McCain. You're the type of guy that are you internet savvy where you could, like, file audio reports to a portal or something?
Alex, I'm old school. I'm 69 years old, so I was one of those guys who grew up without the internet. But I have unlimited local and long distance, so I can.
Well, there's so many great characters out there that are so smart, and you know, I would love to have it where maybe we could find somebody in Wyoming in the town you're in who could work with you as a team and have you go out and do reports and stuff, because this is the power of the people. My big dream would be to turn loose all these great Americans of every race, color, creed, from every region to be filing reports for us. I don't have a ton of money. Most folks wouldn't even want to work for money. Just the coordinating somebody like Wayne Madsen, it's great. We don't have him working with us, but I got to tell him where I want him to go and talk to him. You know, it's a hassle. But I want to have all these great minds involved with us. And you call in maybe once a year and always just absolutely knock it out of the park. And I would like more and more to have people like you be able to, maybe we sent you a DAT machine with a recorder and then you could record commentaries and mail it back to us. But that's just, I mean, there's so many. I really want to turn loose a citizen corps of reporters. That way we'd have people in every corner of the country. Very, very exciting. I'm going to skip this network break so we have more time on this Wednesday edition. Other points you want to make about McCain? Go ahead.
Well, for 5 years, by the way, I've been fighting these criminals here in Sheridan on water fluoridation. And we had a corrupt mayor before who got appointed in the State House of Representatives here. And then he got a formerly anti-fluoride city council member to become pro-fluoride so he would be appointed mayor. So they have some of the most corrupt. You think the politics are corrupt in Texas? Remember, I was born in Texas City, so I know all about Texas politics. And you think corrupt politics are evident in Texas and Louisiana, you should come up to Wyoming and see how corrupt they are up here. They're awful. But I've been fighting the fluoridation of our water, which began earlier this year, began around the first of the year.
That's right. Haven't I seen you in some of the local papers? I think we've covered it because, I mean, look, Harvard admits it's deadly. They've ordered the amount of fluoride in the water cut by half. I bet if you go investigate the water department, I bet they haven't cut it yet.
No, they haven't. As a matter of fact, we need one more new member of city council to replace the old fluoride junkies. One more member of city council, and then we will have enough to shut down the water fluoridation here.
The forced medicating us with a deadly poison that they now admit is brain damaging us, and we wonder why the IQ points have dropped in the last 30 years, 14 points. One decade of regular fluoride use reduces IQ by 10 points on average. I mean, these people are sick freaks. John, I'm going to start getting the name and number of folks that I think could be correspondents or people that give us commentary or people that give us their take on things. I don't know what I'm going to do with this core of people, but the guy called earlier, I think it was from Georgia, talking about going to the Marine Corps recruiting thing, and he had breaking news, people like you. It'd be so good to be able to have folks out there that could be filing reports to Infowars.com and writing articles and just really having boots on the ground everywhere. Very, very exciting. So if you want to give us your name and number, John, I'm going to get that and then put it, create some type of file or something, because I want to start getting these great callers and people. I mean, like David Knight entered one of our contests. We hired him. He's now hosting the show, reaching tens of millions of people every week. Jakari Jackson was in college and, you know, making great grades in RTF and already had a job. We convinced him to move down here. He's doing a great job. You know, people like McBreen was already working for what was the Scripps Tower News Service. We convinced him to quit his job and come here. That's because he entered the contest. But I'm out of money at a certain point, skipping breaks, not plugging like I'm doing now, to where I wish I could go out and just hire a whole bunch of reporters. The problem is you hire an establishment reporter most of the time. They just want you to tell them what to say. I've tried it before, and I'm like, I'm not going to tell you what to say. Go out and investigate, you know. They're like, well, I'm not liberal or conservative. Well, neither are we. We're just common sense. And that's my dream, is there's all these smart, concise people out there that listen. And I'm so humbled that you listen to me, because half the time I'm exhausted. I mean, I got a lot of work. I'm not complaining. It's just that it's kind of like I'm on the field after playing 18 innings of baseball. And sometimes I'm a little tired, and I'm going to swing wide, and I'm going to stumble around. Sometimes, though, I'm going to get a better hit than I would have got in the second inning. But I'm kind of cross-eyed sometimes. I'll be honest with you. I can't believe the stress I can put up with. God's really blessed me with stamina. If people only knew the stuff. I'm not whining about it. It's just crazy. So believe me, folks, I know it's a train wreck sometimes, but I'm doing the best I can, and I got a great crew, and they're just getting better and better, so I'm so blessed. And the world's getting so dark right now that I just fall back on God. And it's not like it's a psychological blanket. It's where I get my strength. I can be exhausted, and I just think about God, and God wants us to protect the innocents, and God wants us to help life on this planet. And then just the strength fills me. And it's just so epic. The battle we're in, I just can't believe we're so prominent in this fight. There are so many well-spoken, smart, incredible people who we need to be involved. And I know you're involved, but I want to see you involved on a bigger level. I wish there were another dozen outfits like InfoWars. I wish there were so many successful, articulate, neat people that showed up on the scene that I was made obsolete. And I could just maybe do polished books or videos fighting the globalist and really contribute in that way. Because I'm so busy, I can't do a lot of polished stuff. I would pretty much sit back if people show up that have got what it takes to take the globalist on. But I know this, so many good people don't take action because you're humble like I am as well. It doesn't matter if you've got a speech impediment. It doesn't matter if you're handicapped. It doesn't matter if you're black or white. It doesn't matter. What matters is you recognize the evil. You don't want to put up with it. You don't want to go along with it. You're not going to stand for it. I mean, folks, they're beginning gun confiscations on Social Security recipients right now. And I feel like I'm losing my soul because my soul's stronger than ever in many ways, but in others, I'm so marinated in this evil that I know they were coming after the Social Security recipients. They're going to do the same thing they've done in Australia and Europe, take away your tax write-off for kids that you desperately need to pay the bills if you haven't inoculated them. They're going to use our dependence in the managed economy. Because even if you work 60 hours a week, you're dependent on the government to get those little tax write-offs for your kids so that you can buy them clothes and take them to the movies or take them to play golf or whatever. And now they're going to get rid of that and shoot them up so they can have seizures and be mentally retarded. I mean, they're just ghouls, folks. They want to hurt us. And I understand it takes me a lot to get my mind around we're really dealing with demons. But I've had globalists at meetings, events, off record, on record, tell me, we're going to destroy you. You'll never stop us. They're like villains in movies. I grew up and would go see movies about villains, and the villain would laugh and say, I'm going to get you. Ha, ha, ha. Here's my plan. And I think, you know, why does the villain give the plan? Why not just kill him? Why do they cackle and do all this? I didn't realize that was criminology. I didn't realize people like Stan Lee understood that when they were doing these comics and that's what villains really do. They really go, ha, 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 I'm going to get you. Here's how I did it. And you didn't know it. I mean, you know, I have to sit there and watch them do this, and then the public's too dumb to even read what they've said or what they've done. We're going to go to break and come back and take a few calls in overdrive. I've done my best. Briefly, like I mentioned, HDFirearms.com, that's a sponsor, great quality products. We've got Knockout, a new form of just natural ingredients known to help you sleep deeper and get better sleep. There's big studies out today that if you don't get rest, it causes cancer and all sorts of mental problems. And it's just so important to get sleep. Just one night of bad sleep can alter your genes. Pulling an all-nighter damages the DNA in our biological clocks. Study shows. Study irregular sleeping patterns linked to cancer. This gives you the deep sleep you need. Knockout. InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. And when you purchase the products at InfoWarsStore.com, it makes this operation possible. And all I can tell you is we'll be as true as we can and as committed and hardworking as we can. But sometimes I'm going to be stumbling around with my eyes crossed. Stay with us. Mike in Canada, thanks for holding her on the air.
So just wanted to, hey, Alex, I wanted to make two quick comments and a review on X2. Two quick comments are, when it comes to John McCain, there's video footage of him saying, laying on a bed in a cast, that he broke his shoulders when he ejected from his plane. We're led to believe that he hurt his shoulders from being tortured. Another thing is if you look at other video of the prisoners being released, most of the prisoners in the background are looking at John McCain with disdain. And John McCain is placed nice and front and center for the camera. But the guys in the background, like I said, none of them are smiling. They're all kind of looking away and looking disgusted, to be honest with you.
I've talked to some of the people. I mean, I've done shows years ago. Most of them are dead now. They say he was a trustee. His dad was the head of the Pacific Fleet. And then he gave away all the codes and just everything. And I've seen that footage when he's getting released after 5 years, and they all look at him like they want to kill him. And that's why he always says, I'm no hero, I'm no... I mean, John McCain is a demon. Look at everything he's done in his life. He reportedly started the fire on the Forrestal. I mean, he is a train wreck.
That's why it's sort of strange how Americans define heroes nowadays. Before, when America was strong and everybody tried to model it, they actually... they put up heroes that didn't kill people. They put up heroes that did everything they could not to kill people, even the bad person. You know, so it's strange how now a hero is actually someone who gets the most kills, like Kyle, the gentleman that's killed the sniper. You guys don't really worship heroes like you used to. It's different now. My X2 review, I've been trying to actually get it out to you for a while. I've been taking X2 for about a year and maybe 2 months. I stopped smoking in April, And I had tried quit smoking before. I'm 33. I've smoked since I was 13. And I tell you, when I tried to quit before, I would see a cigarette on the street and want to smoke it. Now, since I've been on nasal iodine, and I didn't take it to quit smoking, but since I've been on it and I've stopped smoking, I've stopped smoking since April, and I haven't touched it at all. I mean, my best friend quit smoking at the same time with me. He's not a fan of yours, but I got him on the nasal iodine, and he's also not smoking.
Let me ask you a question, because it does change the whole chemical physiology when you're deficient in it, but a lot of folks go through detox within 2 to 3 weeks. Did you have any detox effects?
That's also strange, too, because I had nothing noticeable. And if you think about it, I've smoked since I was 13. You'd think something would happen, but what I did notice was my attitude. I wouldn't get upset about certain things. Days didn't seem so long. Your monotonous schedule of over and over wasn't nearly as terrifying sure. as it was before.
Well, I mean, look, without iodine, you die, and most of the iodine's out of the soils and out of the foods. A lot of the seafood iodine's been contaminated, and you get really pure, clean iodine in your body. I mean, myself, group said when I went on it 2 years ago, he goes, watch, you're going to tan better. He goes, those sunspots you have, a lot of those are going to go away. And they did. And he explained to me physiologically how your body and your skin needs it to even be able to tan. And that's why now, I mean, I barely go out in the sun and I look, you know, coconut brown, which I like. I mean, I think it looks good. I just tan really easy, really good, like I did when I was a kid. And it was because I was deficient. But I felt like crap 2 weeks into it for about a week. And then after it, I described it like when my kids were smaller, I'd put one on my shoulders to, say, go up a hill or a mountain. And when you take them off your shoulders, you feel like you're flying. That's what it felt like after a month was just, but I mean, I don't want to get gross. All this oil, I never had a lot of whiteheads and stuff like that, but it just came out. And I mean, it's dramatic. And a lot of folks experience that. InfoWarsLife.com. God bless you. Thank you for your testimonial. I've got to go. And I apologize the other callers keeping them on hold. I want to hear from Bert and Adam and Wild Mormon and Amy. If you guys can get back in tomorrow at the front of the line, I'm going to do open phones again tomorrow. I promise you'll be first. If John, I always do this, never do it. Will you remind me tomorrow? Get their numbers if they want. We'll call them back tomorrow. Thank you. You're the best, John Harmon, for doing that. So we'll do that tomorrow and hear from those callers. Nightly news is tonight, 7 o'clock Central, Lord willing. Please don't take this place for granted. I know I don't. We're not that special, but believe me, they want to shut up.